Hi guys, welcome back. As you know that we were discussing about the general principles of pharmacology and so general principles of pharmacology, second chapter pharmacodynamics, and in this lecture we will discuss about the quantile cumulative dose response curves. The second name of quantile cumulative dose response curves is also the population curves. Remember that the population curves are also known as the quantile cumulative dose response curves. Okay, so in this curves we will plot the percentage of population responding to a specified drug effect versus dose or log dose. This line says that we will plot a graph dose versus what is the response of that dose on the population. In that, we will take the dose or log dose of a drug on the x-axis, and on the y-axis we will see how the population will respond to that dose of a drug. So here we will take the response, percentage response of the population to that drug which we have taken on the y-axis. On the x-axis. So these quantile cumulative dose response curves helps for the estimation of median effective dose, or we can say that ED50. That stands for the dose that is effective for 50% of population. So to understand this concept, as you know that how much dose we must give to a patient. This is the toxic amount. Let's suppose that this is the toxic amount of a drug. This is the toxic amount of a drug. And this is the minimum effective amount. Okay, minimum effective concentration, you can say that. What is the minimum effective concentration? Minimum effective concentration or minimum amount is the minimum amount of the drug that starts its action. So what is the minimum effective concentration? That the minimum concentration of a drug that is effective, that is called the minimum effective concentration. And what is the toxic concentration? Toxic concentration is the concentration of a drug that becomes toxic in our body. So we should give the patient a dose of a drug in between toxic and minimum effective concentration. It must be in between. It must not be so much that it should become toxic, and it must not be so less that it should not give the minimum effective concentration. So it must be in between the toxic concentration and between the minimum effective concentration, that it should give its effect, it should give its action, as well as it must not be toxic. Okay, right? So now, and how we get this amount, this middle one, how we get this amount? This amount is named as the median effective dose. So these curves helps us for the estimation of this median effective dose. And the second name, how we can get this dose by this one point, that we will apply that dose of a drug on 50% population, and we will get the effective dose of a drug that is effective on 50% population. So what is the quantile cumulative dose response curves? The curves, also known as the population curves, we will take the dose on one axis, on x axis, and we will see the response of a population on that dose, on that dose of a drug. And it helps us in the estimation of median effective dose, or we can say that dose that is effective for 50% population. Okay, that's one dose. So next is the toxicity and therapeutic index. What is therapeutic index? What is therapeutic index? Basically, therapeutic index is the amount of a drug that is safe for us. Then, please skip this one point. Please come here. This is that it compares the toxic dose. How can we get the therapeutic index? Now we are going to calculate the therapeutic index. Then after that we will see what is the function of therapeutic index. First one point, this one we will discuss. After that we will discuss this one. Okay. So it compares the toxic dose TD50, a lethal dose LD50, to the effective dose ED50. Okay. ED50. So this is the formula. This line says this one, that therapeutic index is equal to, this is the toxic dose 50, ED50 or LD50 divided by ED50. Now the question is this, that what is the TD50, what is the ED50, what is the LD50? TD50 is the dose of a drug that is toxic in 50% population. What is TD50? Dose of a drug that is toxic in 50% population. Now we can say that toxic dose in 50% population. And what is ED50? This is the effective dose in 50% population. Now we can say that dose of a drug that is effective in 50% population. And then what is LD50? LD50 stands for the lethal dose in 50% population. Now we can say that dose of a drug that is lethal in 50% population. And again, dose of a drug that is effective in 50% population. So by putting these things, we can get the therapeutic index. So when we get the therapeutic index, then what is the function of therapeutic index? Here, it permits evaluation of the relative safety of a drug. It tells us about the safety of a drug. Therapeutic index is, let's suppose that 10, then this if we increase the drug dose more than 10, if we increase more than 10, then it will become toxic. So it tells us about the safety. Then let's suppose that therapeutic index of a drug is 10. So therapeutic index tells us about the safety, that if you are going to take the dose that is 10, then this dose of a drug will be safe for you. That is safe for you. If you are going to increase than 10, then it will become toxic. It will become toxic for your body. So it tells us about the toxicity. It tells us about the relative safety of a drug, that how much dose of a drug is safe for our body. So this is about that. According to graph, how can we by using this graph, how can we determine a therapeutic index? Okay, remember this formula. What is that? T therapeutic index is equal to TD50 by ED50. So please come here. And you see there, here is a dose of a drug, mg per kilogram, milligram per kilogram, and here is the response of a population. And here is this is a therapeutic curve and this is a toxic curve. Okay, so now we have to determine the therapeutic index. Okay, now we are going to determine the therapeutic index. As you know that, what is the formula? Therapeutic index is equal to toxic dose 50 divided by ED50. So write the formula here that therapeutic index is equal to TD50 divided by ED50. Okay, now please come here. Now see that first we are going to determine the toxic dose 50. Okay, we will determine the dose which is toxic in 50% population. Okay, so see here 50% population. Okay, and we have to move until the toxic, and we have to determine the dose. So 8 milligram is the dose of a drug that is toxic in 50% population. Okay, so what is TD50? TD50 is the 8 milligram is the dose of a drug that is toxic in 50% population. We have to see the 50%, not 100%. If it was 100%, then we will see here. But it is 50%. We have to check the 50%. So 8 is the dose of a drug that is toxic in 50% population. So write therapeutic index is equal to TD50 is equal to 8 divided by, now we have to determine the effective dose, that is dose of a drug that is effective in 50% population. So please come here, this one. So please come here, and you, as you can see that, so this is the dose of a drug that is therapeutic or effective in 50% population. So this is the dose of a drug that is effective or therapeutic in 50% population. So this is, here will come the 4. So therapeutic index will come the 8 divided by 4 is equal to 2. Okay, so in this way we will determine the therapeutic index. How? We will apply this formula, and from this formula you see that first we will determine the TD50, then ED50. By this way we will put here, then we will get the therapeutic index, that is the 2. So now the question arises here again, that what is the therapeutic index? What does mean by this number? This number says that 2 is the safe dose. Let's suppose that it comes 2 milligram. This number says that 2 milligram dose of this drug is safe for our body. This is safe. If we are going to take the 2 mg, if we are going to take the 2 mg, then this 2 mg is effective. This is okay. It is effective. It will give its effect. And it is not toxic as well. So it is giving its response and it is not toxic as well in 50% population. So this is the therapeutic index. This says that this is the average one we have to give to the population. If we are going to increase this one, if we are going to take it 4 mg, then it will become toxic. Then it will become toxic, so we must keep it in low amount. And if we are going to decrease it, then it will not show its response. Then it will not show its proper response. So what is the median or average therapeutic index? That is 2 mg. So this drug dose must be 2 mg. It says about that. Next point says that some drugs have high therapeutic index, some drugs have very low therapeutic index. Okay, so but mostly drugs have high therapeutic index. The drugs which have high therapeutic index, their drugs are not dangerous drugs. That are the safe drugs. We can take, let's suppose that, as you can see, that therapeutic index is the average. Let's suppose that it's a therapeutic index of one drug, that is the, let's suppose that 20 mg, and this is the second drug, that therapeutic index is 2 mg. Okay, so we are going to take two drugs. So if we take the amount of drug, this one, B1, 2 mg, then it means that it is very low, it is very effective. Then if we are going to increase its amount, 3 mg, then it will become very toxic. We need the amount of the dose of this drug must be very low. Why? Because this drug is very toxic. The dose of this drug must be low, 2 mg. So it is very toxic, its amount must be low, and its amount is very high, so it is not toxic. We can take more amount as well. Some drugs have low therapeutic index and some drugs have very high therapeutic index. So the point you have to remember, that the drugs which have low therapeutic index, that are dangerous drugs. Okay, we must be very careful. We must be very careful about their dose. The drugs which have high therapeutic index, that are safe drugs. Those drugs are the safe drugs. So mostly drugs are the safe drugs. Mostly drugs are the safe drugs. They have the high therapeutic index, but some drugs have very low therapeutic index. These drugs are very toxic. So what is the example of safe drug? I am going to give the example of safe drug. Mostly drugs are the safe drugs and high therapeutic index. And example, you can take the penicillin. Penicillin is a safe drug. Why? Because it has high therapeutic index. It has the high therapeutic index. So penicillin is a safe drug. You can take the greater dose of a penicillin for desired effect without any adverse effects. Mean that if we are going to increase the dose of a penicillin to overcome our disease, then there will be the no adverse effect of penicillin. So penicillin is very, very safe drug. And what is the example of therapeutic index, low therapeutic index drugs? That examples, that drugs are very dangerous. And what is that example? The example I am going to tell you a few that are very important, that are very important. And that first one is the theophylline. That is the antibiotic. Theophylline. And second, you can take that digoxin. Digoxin, you can you know that it is the antiarrhythmic drug that control our heartbeats. And third one, you can take the theophylline, digoxin, and warfarin, anticoagulant drug. And the fourth one is the lithium, that is very small size drug. So these four drugs that has the very low therapeutic index, these are the very important drugs. Theophylline, digoxin, warfarin, and lithium. Theophylline is an antibiotic. Digoxin is used in the antiarrhythmic drugs to control our heartbeat. And warfarin is an anticoagulant drug. And lithium is also a small size drug. So let's suppose that I am going to take the example of warfarin. You know that warfarin is the anticoagulant. And it has very low therapeutic index. Very low therapeutic index, what does it mean? This drug is very dangerous. So this drug is very dangerous because it has low therapeutic index. If, let's suppose that its therapeutic index is 2 mg. So if we are going to increase this therapeutic index, then it will become more and more anticoagulant. Then there will be the no coagulation in our body. No coagulation. Then it will lead towards the bleeding. So it will give its adverse effect. Therefore, we must take the warfarin in small amount, because say warfarin has low therapeutic index. Low therapeutic index means that it is a very dangerous drug. It must be taken very small amount. If we increase the more concentration of warfarin drug, then it will act as the anticoagulant. It means that it will stop the coagulant. Then there will be the no coagulation. When there is the no coagulation, then it will lead towards the bleeding, internal bleeding of a man. Internal bleeding in a patient. So it will lead towards the bleeding. So therefore, it is very, very dangerous drug. The next step says that it's very common that steep dose response curves reflects little variability. I mean that if the curves are steep like that, then the variability in the population is very little. I mean that if the curve is steep, then maximum people, it means that the maximum people will give the same response to a drug. Will give the same response to a drug. So there will be the little variability. When there is a little variability, then therapeutic index will be greater. Therapeutic index of a drug will be greater. When therapeutic index of a drug will be greater, then that drug will be safe drug and we can take the high amount of that drug. And it's opposite to that. If the dose response curves are flat, if these curves are flat, then it does mean that there is a greater variability. Mean that the population will respond to a same drug in a different way. Some will respond in another way. Some population will respond to other way. Every individual will respond in another way. So there is a greater variability. Mean that hypersensitivity. More sensitivity to a drug. More sensitivity to a drug. It means that that drug is dangerous drug. That drug has low therapeutic index. You know that drug which has low therapeutic index, that is the dangerous drug. And every population, every individual will have the hypersensitivity with that drug. So that drug has low therapeutic index. Low therapeutic index means that it is a very, very dangerous drug. But the point you have to remember that steep dose responsive curves have little variability, so they have the greater therapeutic index, so they are the safe drugs. And flat dose response curves, then they have the greater variability, so less therapeutic index, and these drugs are dangerous drugs. That point you have to remember, that's important. So now you have understood why quantile cumulative dose response curves are population curves, because this is the response of a drug and population. So we check the population response. So the main function of this is the median effective dose of a drug, that is the effective in 50% population, and used to determine the therapeutic index. And therapeutic index is determined by this way, by this formula, and by using this way. And some drugs have high therapeutic index. High therapeutic index means that drugs are safe, and mostly drugs are high therapeutic index. Example is the penicillin. And some drugs have low therapeutic index. Low therapeutic index means that drugs are very, very dangerous drugs, and we must be very careful in the dose of that drugs. And that drugs, examples, very important examples are these ones: theophylline, digoxin, warfarin, and lithium. And we take the example of warfarin. That warfarin acts as an anticoagulant, and it has the low therapeutic index, meaning that it is a very dangerous drug. If we are going to increase the therapeutic index, if we are going to increase the concentration, if we are going to increase the dose of warfarin, then it is an anticoagulant, then there will be no coagulation, it will lead towards the bleeding. Therefore, we must take the very small amount of warfarin. We must be very careful about this. About this thing, these are very dangerous drugs. So it was about the quantile cumulative dose response curve. So thank you so much, guys.